Good morning, students. I welcome you all in this wonderful session. Today, again, I am here with the topic nouns. As you all know, nouns are the name of person, place, animal, thing, or an idea. We have already seen nouns can be one or many. They can be countable or uncountable. And now today we will discuss gender in nouns. Let's begin. As I told you, noun is the name of a person, place, animal, thing, or idea. If we look at some of the examples, here we have church, pickup, king, a queen, and computer. If we'll see, there are king and queen, pickup an animal. Computer is an electronic device, we can say a non-living thing. And a church, that also we can say a non-living thing or the name of a building. Let's begin with the definition of gender. We can define gender as classification of nouns and pronouns as masculine, feminine, common, or neuter gender. You might have studied different kinds of genders in different languages. As in Hindi language, we have just two gender. What you call them? Just recall. That is, yes, Striling and Pulling. If we talk about Sanskrit language, there are three kinds of gender. What are? Striling, Pulling, and Napusakling. But here in English language, if we talk about, we have how many kinds of gender? Yes, there are four kinds of gender in English language. Masculine gender, feminine gender, common gender, and neuter gender. So let's discuss each of them. Masculine gender, a noun or a pronoun that refers to a male is called to be of masculine gender. Or we can say a noun that denotes a male is said to be of masculine gender. Now recall some of the examples. Yes, boy, lion, dog, uncle, father, brother. These all belongs to whom? Yes, they belongs to masculine gender. Grandfather, tiger, milkman, servant, they are showing to masculine gender. Yes. Now, feminine gender. A noun that denotes a female is said to be of feminine gender. Or we can say a noun or a pronoun that refers to a female is called to be feminine gender. Now recall, who all are females? Yes, there are some females in your family, your nearby. Who all? What you call them? Yes, you call them by some relations like grandmother, lioness, princess, a girl, an aunt, sister, lioness, maid, and some recall some more. Common gender. Now here comes a noun or a pronoun that may be used for both male or female is called to be of common gender. Or we can say a noun that can denote both male and a female is said to be of common gender. Now, who all can be both? Yes, a baby. You're not sure whether it is a boy or a girl. So, baby represents a common gender. Child, parent, students, doctor, teacher, player, scientist, cousin, friend. So, those who can be either a male or a female, that we will call those nouns as common gender. Next comes neuter gender. Very simple, A noun that denotes a non-living thing is said to be of neuter gender. Or we can say a noun or pronoun that refers to a thing is called to be of neuter gender. They can neither be a male or female. Like table, house, chair, school, gold, wood, car, right? But one very important thing about the neuter gender, like collective nouns, are taught to be of the neuter gender. Now recall what all are collective nouns? Yes, crew, flock, class, army, they all denotes to collective nouns. Collective nouns of what? Of living beings. Yes, like if we discuss about class, so class is a collection of students and students are living beings. If we talk about army, army is a collection of soldiers and soldiers are living beings too. But collective nouns are taught to be of neuter gender. So what to remember here? You need to remember that collective nouns are refers as neuter gender. Now we will see the formation of feminines of noun. If a noun or a compound noun is given as masculine gender, how we can change it to feminine gender? So the feminine of a compound noun is formed by changing the part that shows the gender. For example, if it is given man, then what we will write? We'll write woman, or grandfather to grandmother, landlord to landlady, milkman to milkmaid, peacock, peahen, mother-in-law will change to father-in-law, washerman will change to washerwoman. So here what we will do, we'll just change the part of the noun that shows to either of masculine gender or of feminine gender. Now we'll see the next ways of forming the feminine gender from a masculine gender. So some feminines are formed by adding ess or ine to the masculine. For example, lion will change to lioness, hero will become heroine, actor change to actress, god, goddess, tiger, tigress, poet, poetess, master, mistress, waiter, waitress, duke, duchess. Sometimes the form is slightly changed before adding ess. Like here you can see in the spelling of tiger, we'll remove e from here. It will change to tigress. And sometimes we need to change the entire spelling, like you can see here. Duke become duchess. By using an entirely different word, also we can change gender from masculine to feminine. Like husband change to wife, nephew become niece for the feminine gender, horse, mare, monk, nun, lad, lass, cock, hen, bull, cow, king, queen, son, daughter, uncle, aunt, gentleman, lady, father, mother. You can think of many more other examples too. Now what to remember here? You need to remember when a noun changes from one gender to the another gender, like from masculine to feminine or from feminine to masculine, the pronoun in the sentence should also be changed. If we talk about changing the entire sentence from masculine to feminine or feminine to masculine. Let's take an example. My uncle went to market with his son. So if I want to change gender in this sentence, what I will write? Uncle to aunt, and his son will become her daughter. So my aunt went to market with her daughter. For masculine gender, we use he, him, or his as a pronoun. For feminine gender, we use she, her as pronoun. And for neuter gender, we use it or its as a pronoun. Once again, I'll remind you, all the collective nouns are taught to be of the neuter gender. Army, flow, class, herd, crew, all will be considered as neuter gender. Okay? Now one more point. It is now common to refer pet animals and domestic animals like dog, cat, cow, bird as he or she. Like you can say, Tommy was Aish's pet dog. He follows all his instructions. So here we used he for what? We used he for a pet dog named Tommy. I hope you understand all kinds of gender and their conversion from masculine to feminine or feminine to masculine. Thank you.